Hello and welcome to another tutorial from Make the Cut Classroom. In this tutorial, we're going to be going over how to deal with some of the issues that may arise when it comes to completing a trace. Now we're talking about those double lines that you see right here. Now this stencil pattern comes from the stencilworkshop.com. So with that said, if you'd like to follow along with this tutorial, you can go ahead and download this pattern from the Make the Cut gallery by doing a search for flower rose. And that's all one word. All right, so if I go up here to the preview cut, you may be able to see it better. Now, I'm pretty sure that if you were to go cut this out, you would not want this thin strip of paper to be cut out. So let's go ahead and utilize Make the Cut's Shape Magic toolbar in order to help us remove that interlayer or double lines. The first thing that we need to do in order to activate the Shape Magic toolbar would be to actually select the object. And once we do that, you'll notice that the toolbar is now active. We'll then select the layer button. Now what the layer button will do for us, it will actually separate this file into a background and a foreground. We can see this better if we actually take a look at the layer property window. All you'll need to do is to expand the main layer, which is better known as the parent layer, and below that you'll see two layers. Now depending upon how deep within the pattern your double lines are will determine if you have to do another Shape Magic layer. Now in our case, we're going to need to select the foreground, use the layer button again. So the best way to do this would be to select the foreground, and it's actually in the layers property window. Now this will not only ensure that you are selecting the right object, but it also protects you from accidentally moving the shapes. So with the foreground layer selected, we're going to go ahead and do another layer magic. Now looking at the layer property window again, you'll notice that we have three child layers. And all we have to do is delete that top layer, which is the new foreground layer. And once you do that, you can select everything again. And probably the best way to do this would be to click that main layer window that you see right over here on the right. And just go down to the Shape Magic toolbar and push the Join button. And that's it. As you can see, we removed that double lines, all using Make the Cut software. So with that, I'm Rob, and I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you.